Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the That Much difficulty. Last time we helped out Severus on Crate, and today we're gonna help Krog's son Hjalmar in defeating the Ice Giant of Unvik. But first we need to, since we're back at Care Troll the Harbor, we're gonna ask around in the inn here about Unvik and the Giant. So let's look around and see if we can't talk to anyone here.
What do you want?
I'm looking for people from Unvik.
They're dead.
See now, I heard many survived.
Stubborn, get your... What do you want to know?
You there when the giant attacked?
Aye, I was. One of the Jarl's personal guards. I failed him. Led no credence to what the priestesses said, that we'd be punished for robbing the earth of iron. Forging it into blades that men kill one another with, that Freyr would punish us. Perhaps they spoke the truth.
Perhaps they did, but the Ice Giant must have come from somewhere. How did he die?
Jarl of Unvik. Tell me about his death.
Jarl Harald Houndsnout. His whole crew died that night. Wilmar, Wilfred, and Wilhelm.
The Will people.
I reached them too late. Saw the giant dash Wilmar against a rock. He fell right beside me. All his bones broke, wriggling like a salmon on the sand.
Harald was dead by then.
What? No, Jarl fought like a bear. Slicing and dodging and hollering, then slicing again. Couldn't save himself, though.
Okay, and how'd you manage to survive?
How did you manage to survive?
Ran away?
First I heard the giant growl to those flying sirens. Damn me if he weren't giving them orders.
Under stress, men see all kinds of things.
I know what I saw. Rushed to help the Jarl, but one of the cunts sunk her talons in me, lifting me up. Tried to take me to their nest, pecked me apart, I reckon. But I broke loose of her grip. Plummeted from quite a height. Crashed hard, couldn't stand. Last thing I saw, swarm of sirens swooping down on the Jarl, thrashing round him. He yipped, he yelped, he screamed, he hollered. Then silence. The men escorting the women and the children to the ships took my unconscious flesh away and brought me to Ard Skellig.
So you were really, really lucky. Well, thanks for the information anyway.
I should go.
Let's head to Unvik ourselves. Because this man is, troubled.
Aye.
Anyone else I should talk to? Jonas the innkeep.
Aye.
Clannan Creed guard, Skellige. Yavor.
I'm looking for men from Unvik.
Yavor's from the isle, and I once cut those waters with nary a wraith. Could trace you the shoreline in my sleep. A lovely excursion, if not for the bloody sirens.
I'm the one to ask. Me or excellent Hardarok. He's over there. What can a bloke from Ard Skellig know about Unvik?
Heard you trilling a different tune when Hjalmar was gathering his crew. Your love for the Ancrete fade that quick.
Dang dire.
So, why didn't you go with him?
Yavar's from there, or so he claims. And you seem to know these waters. Why didn't you sail with Hjalmar?
Because that kind of expedition needs a true leader. And a whelp looking to collect bumps on his skull can only be its doom.
You'd rather sit in your arse nose in the air, you Zerikinian princess. Brave lad comes along. You sail with him. I'd have sailed with Hjalmar if only those seahorses hadn't banjaxed my knee. Would have sailed instead of sharing a table with a grumpy barnacle like you.
You'd sail with anyone who'd let you aboard, Krog's daughter included.
And what's wrong with Severus, I might ask? So, we know about the sirens, so gotta get there.
Need to get to Unvik.
Another thrill-seeker. Well then, listen close, lest you end in a watery grave. Sail out of port and head southwest. Watch for rocks protruding like pricks out of the water. You'll have to do some tricky tacking to get past them. Some of them shorter, just below the surface, so careful not to scrape right over them. They breach your hull, you're done for. Because just a few minutes in that icy water makes a corpse. One time I remember...
Stick to the point.
Yeah, please.
Oh, fine. Watch for the currents, because they can drag you off course. Dash against the rocks, even. With a bit of luck, you'll land on the same beach where Hjalmar landed.
Okay then, thanks for the information, but I need to go.
Nice talking to you.
Been sitting on my ass way too long right now.
Fair winds to you.
So, let's sail to the island. Well, I don't actually need to, since I bought all those maps, I can actually just warp there. So, see you guys there in a minute. So, we have arrived at Unvik. And apparently there are a lot of ships that have crash landed over here. I need to go quite a bit of ways inland, so I'm gonna skip to that as well. But first I'm gonna add another ability point since we leveled up because of the possession quest. We can see a few sirens over there already. But first, as before, I'm gonna just boost the quench sign intensity. I'm going to be able to use that anyway. Thank you. So, see you guys inland. So a bit further inland, I'm already confronted with an interesting sight. Seems to be a ship here that has been repurposed by the sirens. And there we have the ice giant already. And I'm not even really close to where I need to be already. He feeds them. Well, that's interesting. He's a big fellow. Wait a second. What's in there? And he has a sort of red cloth on his arm. But he was giving meat to something inside of the ship. So that's something we're gonna have to check out. And I'm also gonna check the bestiary as well. So explore the boat's hull. Well, I'm gonna have to find a way to get in there first. But first, the ice giant fled one time in my life from the ice giants, and know what? I'm not a bit ashamed. Rasmund Kvalkje, Clan Tordarok Oarsman. This powerful primeval monster is quite possibly the last of its race. The ice giant resembles a man in many respects, but it's blue as frost and taller than a tree. Though it seems capable of reason, all attempts to communicate with it to date have ended in the same way, in a quick and painful death. So Ogroid, oil, and most importantly the Quen sign, which is handy because we boosted that up quite a bit. Okay then, so let's find a way inside here first. According to the map there should be a road around here, but I don't really see one.
I long to the modest abode.
There's someone in there.
To my doll with his to my to the alcove wherein lies my beauty.
Show me what you got. Shit.
So let's take out the sirens first.
I long.
And let the poor man.
Whose corner is the
And there go the sirens. So let's loot everything. She actually looks pretty normal. Well, except for the fishy bits. Raw meat. Because they looked a lot worse before.
And my blood's coursing slow. It's
tender. Show me what you got.
Turns homeward bows to the modest abode whose corners are rolled.
I'm gonna have to fight that siren first, apparently. There we go. In bloody bits. So let's enter the boat again and see what the man can tell us. Put the sword away and let's see. You have a lovely singing voice, Octo.
I know that song. What are you doing here?
Look, man. Another one. And so many times I've told him.
What's that you say, Wilfred?
I think Wilfred is dead.
To never learn. At least this one heard a song before he died.
So are you one of the Willmen? What's the giant feed you for?
Not much game here, but I saw the giant give you food. Where's he get it?
Don't know, don't ask. Food suits me. Suits my crew.
Over there, on the ground. Hand's got bite marks on it.
What? Where? Wilmar, damn it! You're supposed to clean up. Couldn't keep a secret if your life depended on it. We had a choice. That or
so he's Will Habendon.
And I didn't force anyone. You know, whole crew voted in favor.
Okay, and why did he spare you?
Why did the giant spare you?
Me and the crew and the sirens. We're helping him build a longship. I sew the sails and run away at times, and then the sirens fly out and bring me back.
Why does he need a ship? Where does he want to go?
Promise not to tell no one. I trust my men to take the secret to their graves. But you...
Because they're dead.
Won't tell anyone.
Fine then. The giant's going to sail her out to defeat the gods come Ragnarok. The final battle for the world's end. She'll soon be ready.
Okay then. Well, we kind of know where the skulls will be coming from, but I'm looking for Hjalmar.
I'm looking for Hjalmar on Crete. Word is he came to this isle with a crew, aimed to defeat the giant.
Aye, saw him, as did Wilmar.
Sure it was him?
With his empty eyes.
Wilmar's got eyes like a hawk.
He doesn't even have eyes anymore.
Poor shape they were in, neath the red, fallen Viggy. And just between you and me, that boy is not quite right in the head.
Oh,
the young on Crete was here too.
Okay, and where did they go?
They say where they were headed.
Did they, Wilmar? Oh, aye. Aim to make camp in the old guard tower. Easy enough to find. Stands in the middle of a valley. Garden, absolutely nothing.
Yeah, hilarious. Try to come back for you later.
Try to come back for you once I've found Hjalmar.
Sound awfully sure you'll find him. Maybe you can kill the giant while you're at it. All on your own. They're the same to a man, aren't they, Wilhelm? All think themselves immortal.
Gotta go. So long.
Hey, if you really aim to return, mind bring me some solid twine. You're like to find it in the village. And nails. We're short on nails. Can you remember that? Nails and twine.
I'll remember.
Nails and twine. Okay then. Thank you, Octo. So let's find Hjalmar's camp in the guard tower. So see you there, guys there in a second. So the guard tower is, well, there's not much left of that guard tower.
They were attacked.
And most of his men seem dead.
Broken back. As if he fell from a height.
Probably the sirens that pulled
many
him up.
Wounds. Must have fought for a long time.
Wow, there's like six dead guys over here.
Two people came through here. Separately. These tracks are older. Somebody left the camp before the attack.
Okay, so let's try and follow those footsteps. Yeah, You know what? Maybe there's more clues in the camp. So let's give me a second here. And check out the other bodies. Well, there's not much else I can explore here. No, never mind. I'm gonna follow the tracks. There seem to be a lot of wolves on the right here, but I'm hoping I don't even need to fight those. That looks like a bear of some kind. So let's follow the footsteps. They go off the track here. Where does this lead?
Landed smack in a Necker's lair and cut the beast down. Hardy folk, these Skelligers.
Interesting.
Landed smack in a Necker's lair and cut the beast down. Hardy folk, these Skelligers.
So, and here are the other footsteps again. Yeah. Okay, let's follow these. Okay, more Neckers.
One arrow in each. Good eye.
Yeah. I hope so, for this man's sake. I don't really know what I'm following right now. Abandoned village. Just save a little, just in case something happens. Blood.
Bleeding heavily. Strength probably waning.
So we're about to find someone, I presume.
Kept more going, blood. Though he could barely walk.
There's a large tower at the end there. Don't really know what I'm looking for right now, but the marker keeps going.
Lost a lot of blood. Couldn't have gone much further.
There's more blood over there. So, okay. There's a dead guy
Took
over
a
here.
Second arrow here. Got him good this time. Now where'd that archer go?
And the Hornwall horn? You have a new quest item prepared for use by placing it in an appropriate slot in the inventory panel. Okay then. Don't I have... No. So let's equip it. So we can use that horn, although I might not want to do that, but hey, let's try that. Okay then. There's a lot of tracks around here.
Trolls. Dragged him into the cave. Wonder if he's still alive.
Let's check it out then.
Archer was wounded too.
Let's follow the blood and if there are rock trolls. Well, there's one over there. Is he aggressive? Kinda looks like it. Yeah, he is. You want a piece of this? He doesn't seem to be doing all that much. So let's finish him off. There we go. So that's one down. Find the trolls captured using... Find a man the trolls captured using your witcher senses. So there's another troll over here. Might want to take care of this one as well. So added some Ogroid oil. So one, two, and three makes him go in defense. Oh. There we go. Another one bites the dust. That looks deep. Don't want to fall down there. So let's check out the other side of the cave. There's another troll over there, but I don't think he saw me, so let's go around.
Something cooking over there.
Ooh, that's not a good sign. Oh, I can go in here. There we go. There's the trolls. And I think they're eating the man already. They don't look as aggressive as their
cooking
brethren.
Cooking.
Hey, you there! Help me! Water's getting hot!
Oh, the man is still alive.
Shut it.
I need that man.
No! We went home and from mirrors.
Alright, let's play for him.
Play me for the man, then. If I win, I take him with me. If I lose, I'll jump in the pot, too.
Good! Good!
Five riddles! Why?
No bubble! First riddle. Lot eats, lot drinks. Big he be, skit big he. Big he bash.
A troll?
A troll, of course.
Good troll. Now you ask.
This is a bit of a golem moment, isn't it?
I'm light as a feather, but even a troll can't hold me for long.
Air. I'm pretty good at riddles. I think it's air. I've never done this part.
Piss. Riddle hard, human cheat.
I won fair and square.
Stupid riddle. Feather. Troll not hold. Not piss.
Can you walk?
Ooh, looks a bit red.
Let's get out of here.
So that's one man freed. But sadly not Hjalmar. Look at him steaming.
Never go in a sauna again, long as I live. Other than that, I think I'm fine. You saved my life. How can I thank you?
You can help me find Hjalmar.
Hjalmar? Curious where he is myself. Him and the whole crew. Something must have happened. Otherwise, he'd have come looking for me after I went missing that night. I know he would have. Wait now. Why are you looking for Hjalmar?
Krok sent me to help Hjalmar.
Krok sent me here to find Hjalmar. New king will soon be chosen on Ardskellig. Everybody's waiting for the young Ankrate's return.
So it's started already? Hjalmar, ruler of all Skellige.
Doubt he's cut out for it.
Hjalmar's irresponsible, stubborn, and heeds no counsel. But he's a born leader. Been mates since we were lads. With him, man, Ceres.
Ceres has put forth her claim to the throne as well.
Ceres? But she's... Well, she's...
Probably better than her brother.
Like father, like daughter.
What about Krak? He support her? He let her set off on some daft quest.
She's already done.
Especially since Sarah set out without telling him.
Nor did she tell me. Where'd she go? Who'd she take with her?
Speaker Og. And no one.
She went alone? Damn the dogs! If Hjalmar'd only... Has she come back, do you know?
Yeah, she's back. Did what she set out to do, too.
Thank the gods.
Are you in love with her? So, how'd you get separated?
How'd you get separated from the others?
Had to watch for the night. Saw Egnar of Faro steal Hjalmar's Hornwall horn. One he uses to drive away sirens. Bugger snuck out of camp. I followed him. No idea what got into that ginger head of his. Told Hjalmar not to take him with us 1,000 times at least.
And? You catch up to him?
Aye. In these caves. Bastard screeched so loud he drew the trolls. Thought the buggers would eat me right then. Dropped me in a marinade instead. Decided I was ready to cook today. Would have been the end of me if not for you.
Yeah, okay, so where do you think he is?
Any idea where Hjalmar thought he might find the giant?
We'd learned where it has its lair, in the caves above the village. Hjalmar decided the best way there would be to cross the lake. Viggy the Loon insisted he knew a better way, through the mines. But none of us fancied strolling into a monster pit.
Okay, thank you for the information.
I know enough. So long.
Wait! I'll go with you. Luckily the trolls didn't use my bow for kindling.
Good idea, I can always use the extra help. Especially since we're up against a good ice giant. Okay, so, cross the lake. We don't really need to check up on the ruins of Urskar anymore, since we now know where he might be, where the ice giant is. So let's cross the lake. And I'll see you guys there in a minute. Okay, don't fall off. How do I even get there? So, when we cross the lake, we're getting close to another little village. Dwarf Ruins. And Hjalmar is fighting a... Oh, that actually just puts them down. That's actually really funny. Hello, Hjalmar. You look like your father.
Fallen! I was sure you died. Where have you been?
Ceres has gone to Speaker Og, alone. Couldn't wait, no. Had to sneak off, as if you were afeard of someone stealing the giant out from under you.
Ceres, she staked a claim to the throne then. And you'd have rather gone with her.
I'd have liked to have the choice.
Wait! Still need to thank you, Geralt of Rivia. I'll never forget you came to my aid.
You are welcome. Where's the rest of your crew?
Where's the rest of your crew?
Fought our way through a swarm of sirens to get here.
Ooh.
Only a handful of us left after that battle. Now we're but 3. The sirens tore Leif up good. We should see to his wounds.
He's dead.
What? Nah, he's just unconscious. Lost a bit of blood.
He looks pretty dead.
Trust me.
Yep, he's gone.
Swore he'd sink his blade into the giant's heart. Swore it on the bones of his ancestors.
Well, then you'll have to do it for him now, don't you?
Coming with me?
Stupid question.
Join us, Geralt.
Do I have a choice? So, let's find a way into the giant's lair. It should be in a cave below here.
See, you're raring to go.
So I'm actually faster than you guys, so I don't know why you're yelling at me. Apparently this guy runs faster than a Witcher. You can hear the crows.
Know the Isle well.
I've never been here before. Guess you could say I've never been fond of Clan
Enormous Horse Sonny is.
In fact, no one in Arch Skellig's especially fond of them.
Okay then, let's go. Because I didn't mean to talk to you. It's only the same button as sprinting, so that's why that happened. So I won't sprint if Folan's in front of me, because we're almost there as well. That's closed off. This is gonna be a long episode.
Geralt, help me smash that. We're sure to reach the giant's cave this way.
Are you insane? Seriously, that was the way to go?
Position myself so as to keep the giant in sight.
Okay then. So that's an extra scene because you could have been here without Folan, of course. So, the giant's cave. I'm gonna save. Because this is a rather big battle.
Careful now. One odd step and you can wake him.
Because he's apparently asleep.
Hey, quick! Let me out before he wakes!
And there's another one that's still alive.
Wait. Know what they call Viggy? The loon. For good reason, too. Best he stay in there till we finish with the giant.
What? You out of your bloody mind, Uncrate?
I thought he was your comrade.
He is. Which is how I know what he's like to do.
Poor man. We're gonna free him first.
Let's free him. Giant's pretty big. Looks pretty mean. We could use an extra blade.
Even one swung by a madman?
I heard that, Uncrate. Let me out right now.
Shut up!
I'll look for the key.
So, this is a really annoying one, because the giant is right over there. If I walk two steps in that direction, I'm gonna wake him up. I also need to avoid the snow, and I think the key is over there in that cage. So, need to walk really carefully. And Geralt is not one to.
No closer, he's mine!
And the snow will wake him up, because that's something I missed when I did this the first time around. There we go. Shut the f.
I sat in a bloody troll cauldron with nary a murmur.
So let's slowly walk around here. And let Viggy out of his cage. So I don't know if the first time I played is that hint was there that you need to avoid the snow, because I took two steps and just woke up the giant, which in turn just smashed the cage to bits and squashed Viggy. So there we go.
Let's get out of here.
Right, just as soon as I kill him.
Yeah, he is a madman. So, Ogroy Doyle. As he doesn't care about shields. But Viggy is a great distraction, though. And he doesn't seem to be losing health. And there goes Geralt. So that's the point where Viggy would have died if he would have been in that cage. And now the giant has an anchor as a weapon. Fuck this. Hopefully he's still distracted by everybody else. So one hit always depletes your quench time. Since he's really distracted by Viggy and Hjalmar and Fallon, of course. This is actually a pretty easy fight. Just keep hitting him from the back with heavy attacks. And Viggy doesn't seem to be dying, so... There we go. And in the neck. Or in the shoulder this time. And there go his bowels. Whew. And there went another arrow, but...
I knew we'd best him.
Completed the Lord of Anvik.
You daft bastard.
So I think this is the maximum amount of people you can actually have on this quest. And they're losing their minds slowly.
Where are the others?
They're all dead.
Thanks for your help, White Wolf. Geralt the Giant Slayer. I'll make sure the Skald said it in song.
Thank you. Any glory stemming from the giant's death should be yours, or thanks, so be it. Well then, let's give him the glory.
Hjalmar the Giant Slayer sounds better. It was your venture. You deserve the glory.
Believe you're right.
Of course
let's
you
get
are.
Out of here.
I'm gonna take a look around first, but...
I wanna look around some more.
In that case, I'll meet you on the beach, near the port.
Because I think there's a bit of loot here as well, so I'm gonna loot the giant anyway. There we go. And after the looting is done, we can safely exit the cave. So I'm gonna take a little break, because this has been quite the recording session since I did this and Cyrus's quest in one long run, which took about 2 hours in its totality. But I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate the support. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!